more on how to be kind to oneself.
Okay. Anybody want to throw out a competing topic? And then we'll vote? No takers. So that's a subject I've spoken about numerous times in numerous ways. There are CDs you can purchase for a nominal sum that address it in depth. But hearing you ask the question, it does pop into my thought that there's a few things immediately come to mind that I don't recall ever having said. So let me say a few of those. And this comes under the heading of far more general and global. Global in the sense of you. So what does it mean to be kind to yourself? And you can slice it two ways. The global part is it means loving yourself. We even have a CD titled Loving Yourself. And that's one whole side. That's the bigger side. And I want to say something about it. The lesser side, meaning just there's less of it, smaller, is the little tips and how-tos that aren't about the deeper, bigger subject of how to love yourself, that are simply about how to do little things that involve more what we think of when we hear the word kind or kindness. And there's a very simple, and so simple, and it's so elemental, and it's so kindergarten, that no matter how much you would say it to people, and I've never said it, so I don't know, but it's obvious to me that no matter how many times or how you say it to people, most people will be very unlikely to ever do it at all, because it's just too easy. People don't like, the human mind does not like easy. It wants to hear a complicated formula for how to improve, how to do whatever that involves expanding your consciousness. So how to be kind to myself? Well, it should be a complicated thing that I have to achieve and then I'll be kinder, you know. But it's not like that. The very simplest way, and you can use this moment to moment, anytime, anywhere, and it's going to sound so ridiculously simple that you will probably not notice how your mind will initially, automatically, in a split second, reject it as stupid. You fools. Which is, you can at any moment ask yourself whatever you're doing, thinking, feeling in any given moment. It's not just actions, not just what you do. It's also what you think. In fact, more than anything, it's what you think. The thought that you're having now, but also what you do, the actions you take, the feelings you experience, the conditions you create for yourself. You can ask yourself in any of these dimensions, is this being kind to myself or not? You can simply ask yourself, am I being kind to myself right now? Is what I'm doing now, and even is the thought I'm entertaining right now, a way of being kind to myself, or is it more in the direction of being unkind to myself? Can't be simpler than that. How do you be kinder to yourself? By asking yourself, am I being kind or unkind to myself right now? The trick is, are you with me? The trick is right now. Not a minute ago, not last week when I was yelling at myself in the mirror, not next week when I'll be yelling at my wife or my husband. Right now, this thought, this action, how I'm holding the fork eating dinner right now, taking off my socks right now, whatever it is. I'm just saying absurd examples because it really applies to anything. You can ask about any given moment, whatever you're doing, thinking, saying, feeling, acting, you can ask the dimension on the dimension of, is it more towards kind to myself or is it more towards unkind to myself? And if the answer is unkind, stop it right then and there. Change it right then and there. Because it isn't hard to figure out how to do it slightly differently so that's more in the direction of kinder to myself. You know, you might notice when you ask this at lunch that you're eating too fast. Is that kinder or unkind to myself? And what do you do if you answer it? I guess it's more toward unkind. You start eating a little more slow. So we don't have to do the Heimlich maneuver. Somebody had to, did you have your hand?
Yeah, I wanted to say something because the more I put that into practice of being kind to myself, what I noticed was initially there was almost, internally there was a pain response because the tendency is so much to be cruel and mean. Like the ego's life is often cruel, just cruel and mean, that by actually slowing things down and being nice to myself, there was a physical pain. And it was almost like, no, I was like really firm, no, I'm not doing that anymore. And there was a pain, but then there was a momentum to it, and it just it's become easier and easier.
It's very, very, very hard at the beginning, and very hard to remember at the beginning. And it doesn't matter how you do it, how you ask it, how you bring your awareness to that dimension. But I'm giving you a very, very, very foolproof, because it's the simplest way possible, method for dealing with this, which is, how can it get simpler then? In any given moment, is whatever I'm doing, thinking, or saying more in the direction of being kind to myself, or is it more in the direction of being unkind? If you can't figure that out, you got more important problems than being kind to yourself. Much bigger problems. It's so simple. And it's so in a sense moronic that people don't want to do it because they feel stupid. No, I might be kind of ugly. No. You know, people want complicated spiritual theories of cosmology and the functioning of the ego and the human soul and how to be kind by raising your soul to the decibel level of, you know, whatever. Just ask yourself, what am I doing? Am I being more kind or unkind in this? Obviously, you can do that in your relations with others, too. But I don't suggest going there until you've done it with yourself. Because, well, you figure out why.
I think I'm going to start just with my socks, because when you said socks, I know how many times I get irritated if I'm feeling kind of fat and I can't even get my socks off. And that just rung a bell there. It's like, it's that simple. I mean, I get so pissed. Sometimes I just feel irritated because I have to struggle to get my socks on. So I tell Tosh to do it.
Pan down the fat feet over there.
I already did.
Get my good side.
Look at those elephant ankles. Whoa. It's a perfect example because it's so nothing. It's so... seems okay. It seems okay to be frustrated and say to yourself, what the hell's wrong with my feet? I'm getting so fat. It seems like there's no problem in that. That is majorly, majorly, majorly being unkind to yourself. The problem is it seems so nothing. It seems like, what's the problem if I get, you know, say this to myself? Well, that's your foolishness. The problem is immense. The problem is you are in the habit of doing this again and again with 1,000 different things, day in and day out. Because it's not just the socks and that thought. It's the habit pattern in 1,000 other things exactly the same. And when you add all that up, how can you ever, ever, ever feel okay? If you feel okay for a minute here, an hour there, it's an accident. It's just a lull while you're waiting to tear your head off with what you're going to do wrong next, or what's not okay next, or what's all screwed up next. And it's always about you, and it's always your fault, and it's always not right. Except the example, because those are huge feet you got there. No, it's the perfect example, thank you, because it's so nothing. It's like most people would say, ah, big deal. You know what? Correct. Very big deal. Life is not the big things. Life is the little things. Moment to moment, day to day, this week, next week, last week, this month, this year. It's the little things. 99.9% of life is all the little things. It's the little things that matter. You can't change any big thing without changing a ton of little things. So that's the practical how-to, one of them. There's many, but on the kindness part. But let's plug it into the bigger, more globally applicable love side. Because being kinder to yourself, the desire, the recognition that it's good, that you should be kinder to yourself, is about loving yourself. And loving yourself more is about loving everyone more, and loving everyone more is about being more life-affirming. So there's one elemental thing that's important to understand that usually, unless somebody lays it out for you, it doesn't occur to us. So think of the sun and the rays of the sun, and everybody knows, everybody's who's gotten past the seventh grade knows that life would cease literally instantly. There wouldn't even be a nanosecond if the sun suddenly ceased. On this planet, life would be annihilated, would be extinguished, would go poof in a 1/1,000,000,000th of a nanosecond. What do you think that energy is? What do you think sunlight is? What do you think the meaning of that is? Not just the meaning, the actual essence. The sun is, in many cultures, a symbol of life, growth, and love. Why? Because it actually is love. Anything that grows you, sustains life in you, is love. So many things you don't recognize as love, if you look at it from that aspect, from that understanding, turn out to be love. So understand, just like the only thing that will grow a blade of grass, a tree, a plant, the only thing that will grow anything on this planet is sunlight. Without sunlight, nothing grows, not you, not nothing. That's not just symbolic. That's because only love grows things. Nothing else. All the self-criticism in the world has never grown you one iota. That's why no pain, no gain is nonsense. Pain doesn't grow you. Love grows you. So if you recognize this, then you understand a little more clearly that being kind to yourself is really, truly growing yourself. It's the sunlight, it's you giving sunlight . And why shouldn't you give yourself sunlight? Why should you sit in the dark? What's the problem to give yourself sunlight? Only love transforms you. Only love grows you. Only love heals you. Only love improves you. Everything else that says it improves you, it fixes you, it helps you, it benefits you, it grows. Everything else that claims to or that people say does is either mistaken or a lie. Only love takes you forward. Everything else either holds you in position or pushes you back. So whenever you hear anybody say, such and such will improve you, such and such will assist you, help you, ask yourself, okay, is what he or she is talking about, does it represent love? Is there love in it? If there is, then they may be saying something that's true. If you can't get a sense that love is involved, either they're deluded or they're purposely lying to you or they just don't know what they're talking about. So I'll coin a new phrase here and now today for the all, not just you, but all you good folks of YouTube. So the hell with no pain, no gain. No love, no gain. You heard it first.